Hello everybody, welcome to this week's BIM 360 Weekly Monday Trading. This is Hard Hat Matt reporting live from beautiful scenic Waltham, Massachusetts. This week we're going to take a look at BIM 360 Glue and the brand new features that came out just hot off the presses. For folks attending the webinar for the first time, what we're going to do is we're going to go over some ground rules real quick. We're going to keep the webinar under 1/2 hour. Be sure to end by 4:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. You all need to know that you are attending anonymously and you're all in listen-only mode, which means that if you do have a question, what I need you to do is open up the GoToWebinar panel and enter your question into the question dialog box. At the end of the webinar, I'm going to circle back around and answer everybody's questions, so be sure to type them on in. Let's get started. So, the new features that came out in BIM 360 Glue, actually just this weekend, maybe even this morning actually, were focused around our enterprise account customers. What can happen now is host administrators can log into the system and gain access to grab information about their account. One set of reports that you're going to have is going to give you really strong, great insight across all of your projects on how they're being utilized. There's a report, Activities by Project, which is going to illustrate overall activity of each one of your projects. There'll be another report that takes a look at model iterations per project. And what this really is a great indicator that your teams are using BIM 360 Glue as it was designed, as an iterative tool to constantly evolving and improving your models. The third activity-driven report that you're going to have is taking a look at how many markups are being performed by each project. And we like to look at this as a demonstration that your project team members utilizing the markup feature are really, really grasping the capabilities of the system as a collaboration tool. You can take a look at these reports based around activities by week, by month, or a total perspective for the lifetime of the project. When you're accessing these reports, they're only accessed through the web portal currently. They're not available in the client yet. And so you can go ahead to this URL here and access them. There's another set of reports for host administrators, again for our enterprise customers, where you can take a look at how your users on your account are utilizing the system. So what you're able to do is take a look at all the members of your account, the users, based on the status of them, by the project, or by their access level. There's also a really great report in there that actually shows historically active users per month, right? And what you're going to see when I'm showing you the demonstration is actually it spikes up in January because the first month we started capturing this data historically for you is in January. So prior months will always be zero, right? But moving forward, we'll start tracking those for you. Other really great enhancements to BIM 360 Glue that just came out are when you are visualizing your clash results. What we're doing is we're bubbling up and surfacing the clash's overview pane. And the intent of this is to give you a great high-level perspective and understand better understanding of how where your clashes are grouped by the various models. I would like to take this time to remind everybody that we do need you to go ahead and the next time you log into Glue, make sure you update your version of Microsoft .NET Web Framework to version 4.5. All right, this is going to be really important for you to be prompted to do it if you haven't already done so. Let's get started. So, here I am. I'm logged in to my host account, Autodesk University, which is set up in our system as an enterprise account, right? Remember that these reports I'm about to show you are for our enterprise customers only at this point in time. Additionally, you need to be logged in as a host administrator to access these reports. So I'm logged in as Matthew DePaulis. Of course, he's a host administrator for Autodesk University. And the way I get to these reports, I'm going to tap here on my profile, and I'm going to go to Administration Overview. Here I am. It brings me to these handy reports we talked about. They're the activities-driven reports and then the users or members-driven reports we have here. All right. These activities reports, all right, what you can do with these is you see and understand how many activities have been performed on each one of the projects in your account. And you can see, you know, how many activities within the past week, month, or over the total lifetime of the project. Right, activity is just a great indicator that the system is being used and folks are engaging with the system for you. Additionally, what you'll see is any of these reports, not only can you see them by week, month, or total, but traditionally you can also click on View All of Projects. So right now it's listing the top five, but if I say View All Projects, it will list all the projects on my account. You can see I have a whole bunch of them in here. Right? You can also change your sort order, of course. The next report we're going to talk about here is model iterations by project. Right? Remember, multiple iterations of models, what this is going to depict for you is that this is a very healthy project, one in which we have continual updates to the model, continual improvements to the model for us. You'll also notice on this report that you have a couple different colors here. Right? When you hover over them, it'll tell you what that means. Right? So this bluish tannish color, I guess, or aqua, this is the number of the 25 model revisions, model iterations, 19 of them were new versions. And when I hover over this tannish color, I see that the other six of them actually were model, were merged model versions. So we just merged them up. The next report we're going to take a look at is the markups by project. All right, this markups by project is a great indicator that your team is leveraging the collaborative nature of the system. I'm going to flip on over now. We can understand how users on my account or in my host site are utilizing the system. What members? So for each member, I can see how many have been added to my host account. 142, and of them, how many have been activated, how many are pending, and how many are suspended. And then we could see how many members, all right, are on each one of the projects. And then what we could do is take a slightly different perspective. We could take a look at users or members of my host site based on their user role and permissions. And so we have full users, reviewer users, administrators on a project level, host administrators, and then limited users. And here's this great report we were talking about where it's going to start to track historically how many active users you've had in your host account per month. And we're going to see all host accounts are going to have a spike for January because we weren't tracking data prior. All right, great. So those are the new host administrator reports for our enterprise customers. Right? For all users have access to clashes, of course. One of the new great features that we have in here is something that you may already be familiar with, but what we're doing is when you're running these clash results, we're bubbling up and we're going to show you this clashes overview. Right? If you close this window, you want to reopen, you can always just click back on overview. And so here what we've done is I've run a clash for the first floor HVAC versus all other models. And what we can see is the clash results is giving me each model, so HVAC level one is one of the models, versus the rest of the models. And I can see where there are clashes. And then I could take a look at the rest of the models associated with this clash result and how many clashes there were with it against the selected initial model that we clashed it against, and then against all models. And this is good. It's going to help us even go ahead and even drill down in, right? So I can see here when I have HVAC level one, I've got a whole bunch of clashes here. But if I wanted to see the HVAC level one versus the first floor, the second floor framing, I'll just tap right here on this. And what it'll do is it'll highlight and now display only those clashes that appear here. And then we can, of course, we can still click down on in, and it'll zoom us into where those are. Those are the same features we always had. All right, so those are the brand new features that came out in Glue. Login, try them out, particularly for our enterprise host administrator customers. Be sure to check out those brand new reports and give us your feedback. We're going to go and start answering questions now. All right, the first question that came through was, how do you define an active user? Okay, so this must have been taking a look at the reports. And when we're looking at members, all right, so active members by month, all right, the way that we define active is any user or any member that logs into the system, right? And they could have logged into the web portal. Maybe they're even just a reviewer. They could have logged into the Windows client, or they could have logged in through the iPad application. Another question is, what is an activity? So I think what that might have been referring to is, under activities, these reports, they're taking a look at activities by project, right? So 380 activities on the Audubon project. What does that mean? Right. Well, what an activity is, it's like anytime you do anything or create anything. Some examples of common activities that are logged or transactions that are logged in our system is anytime you upload or merge or reversion a model, that's considered an activity. Anytime you run a clash report, anytime you create a view or even just add a markup, that is considered a activity, right? And we keep track of all that transactional information. So that's what an activity is. Another question on here, can you print these reports? All right, that's a really great question. You know, I figured I'd be asked this question a lot, and the answer is no. But, you know, before we just kind of jump to the answer, it's why do you want to, right? The idea around printing a report is interesting. You know, I think it made sense at a point in time, but we're evolving to a system that is interactive by nature and constantly evolving and changing. And we need to embrace that and understand that actually, instead of actually having a static report, which is out of date as soon as I run the report, the better thing to do is give folks access to the system. Right, give folks access to this collaborative environment so they can come into the system and they can see and interact with this information real time rather than looking at and making decisions or judgments based on old information that's stale or stagnant. Okay, so currently you cannot print out these reports. The idea is that we want to make it super simple for you to give access to folks to come right into the system and see the data real time, rather than an old out-of-date report, in which case you never remember which one is the most up-to-date one and the right one anyways. So maybe a little bit of a long-winded answer, but currently you cannot print out these reports. All right, last question on there. If anybody has any other questions, please enter them into a question dialogue panel now. All right, the last question I have on there right now is, what other reports are you planning? So this is a great question. So these are brand new. This is our first iteration. This is our first pass at this brand new feature functionality that didn't exist yesterday. You have access to it now, so that's really awesome. All right, moving forward and looking forward, it's really important that we get your feedback on how these reports are adding value or fitting your needs. It's really important that we get feedback on what other reports might be interesting to you or might help you do your job or make informed decisions. And so what I'd like to do is strongly recommend that if you have some ideas or some feedback, what you could do is you can come here and you can say, give feedback and enter some suggestions. What we do with these suggestions, we don't commit to building all of them, but unless we know about them, right, we have less of a chance of building. So definitely give us your suggestions and your recommendations. When you do this, describe why that is important to you. Describe why that's compelling. What's your business reason? How many folks will affect? What decisions could you make with that information? And that will help us do a better job in picking the right reports to build, for example. Okay. So the direct answer to your question is, I'm not sure what the next reports are going to be. It's going to depend a lot on a lot of the feedback we get. Okay, great. There was another question out there. The last one on here is, are there any reports that show trends of model/modeling activity? Right. I think that there are reports here that show model activity. In terms of what show trends, These are what reports we have, right? So trends, I start thinking of, I hear trends, I think, over time, and I start to think of things like the report we have with active members by month, right? So the only report that we're showing over time is active members by month. This is what we have right now. But when you have these other great ideas, like I said, go ahead and enter some feedback in here for us so that we can, you know, consider that when we take the next pass at the new features and functionality we build in. Great. Everybody, thank you so much. I hope you have a great start to the week. Oh, a couple last things real quick. So first, if you want to get some more information on what's new, these new features and functionality that came out, remember you can always click up here and you can go to help. And from the help menu, there's always a new BIM 360 glue you can click on. Right? So all the things we went over today. Additionally, I had thought I would be also demonstrating the new features and functionality that came out for BIM 360 Field, but the release hasn't quite hit yet for our mobile iPad application. It's pending with the Apple Store. So be sure to tune in next week to hear about all the new features and functionality coming out in BIM 360 Field. Hope everybody has a great week. We'll talk to you soon.